How do you convert your leads to actual clients? Let's find out. The journey from a potential client to a client is delicate. It's like a dance where you need to take the lead and take all the right steps. If you do it right, your client and you will have a great time and build a great relationship. But if you miss a step, your client will leave you and dance with someone else. So the first step in our delicate dance is we're going to meet the client. Then we're going to define the project. And the third step is to make a proposal. Fourth, we're going to present the proposal. And the last step in our delicate dance is we're going to close the deal. Now, potential clients that reach out to you can have different questions. They can have like this really specific question, like I want a promotional video for this and this and that. Or they can have more of an abstract question, like I want to use video in my strategy, but I don't know how, what, or when. Now, in both cases, it's important to first meet your client to learn more about them and their product.
Hello, my name is Yoshiyami Tanaka. Thank you very much for being here. I would like to take the opportunity today to, first of all, get to know each other a little bit and to talk about the project and how we can help you with our services. So I'll tell a little bit about me and about our services. And after that, I have a lot of questions to get to know you. So like I said, my name is Yoshiyami Tanaka. I'm a filmmaker based in the Netherlands. I've been producing films for the last 14 years now. And I have a passion for education. So I mostly direct promotional videos and educational videos. So that is a little bit about me. Now I'm very curious about you.
Okay. Well, my name is Kylie and I'm from Greenhouse. And I would like to have a promo video with great drone shots, a real snappy edit style, and a great hip-hop-ish track.
It's awesome that you already have like this plan and this image, these images about how you like the video. But to get the best results, we need to take a step back.
Okay.
And to do that, I have a couple of questions that I like to go over with right now.
Okay.
So I will also write down the answers to have more information. Yeah. So what would be the target audience of this promo video?
Good question. We focus mostly men in the age of 25 to 40. Our products are high end, so we aim for ambitious people that are willing to spend a bit more than average on a bike.
I already get to know a little bit more about your brand and the people you sell to. What would be the main message we like to have in this promo video?
We are not just a bike. We have a great design and we only use the best materials for our product. We are not the bike for an average Joe. We're really an exclusive brand.
It's kind of a luxury product then.
Exactly, yeah.
At the end of the promotional video, we communicate a call to action.
Yeah.
So that is an action that we like the viewer to take.
Yeah.
Now, what would be a great call to action for this video?
We would like them to visit the website to take a look at our bikes.
So visit the website, check out our bikes at www.blahblahblah.
Exactly, okay. Yeah.
Where are we going to publish this video?
On our social pages. We don't have any plans for campaigns.
So no paid campaign?
No paid campaign, no.
When will this project be a success for you?
Well, let's see. We have 20,000 followers on IG. So let's aim at 10%, if that is feasible.
10% of those followers?
Exactly, 10% of 20,000 followers.
And they will visit the website?
Yeah.
All right.
Hopefully.
So that is 2K followers to visit the website after watching the video.
Exactly.
I think that's a bit high. I think if you look on best practice and research online, you will find around 5% that is convertible.
Okay.
So if that is an option for you as well.
Yeah, it's okay to start with, yeah.
All right.
Of course.
We like 5% of the followers
of our RG, yeah.
Okay. All right, and then I have one other question, and that is about the budget. I will give you three ranges, and please let me know which one is suitable for your budget. So I've got 1 to 3K, 3 to 6, and 8 to 12K.
I think 3 to 6K will work for me. Yeah, that would be great.
All right, these were my questions.
Cool.
You passed the test. Congratulations.
Wow. Thank you.
Do you have any questions for me?
No, I don't have any at the moment. Maybe later, but then I will give you a call.
The next step is that I'm going to make a proposal for you.
Okay.
That will include the quote and it will also include a concept, more of an idea.
Yeah.
I will reach out to you next week to make a new appointment to present the proposal, and then we can move forward after that.
Perfect.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, the first two steps are done. We've met with the client, we've defined the project, and we've gathered all the needed information to go to step three, and that is making a proposal for the client. So creating a proposal is a matter of making three documents. One is the briefing, second is the quote, and third is the storyboard. I'm going to start with the briefing. So for the briefing document, I used the same file that I had in front of me during the meeting. Now, I already have my notes in here, and I'm now just going to rewrite it a little bit to make it a complete briefing. So I add a little bit about the project, what we're going to make, what the target group is, what the main message is, the call to action, where we're going to publish it, and stuff like that. Now I add this to the proposal to make sure the client knows what my takeout is from the meeting. And it's very useful to avoid miscommunication. In the storyboard, I draft out the main idea for this video production. I focus on the different shots that I have in mind and on the storyline. Check out this video to find out how I make a storyboard using FilmKey. Now the client gave me a budget for 3 to 6K, so I'm going to aim for 5K. And the first thing I'm going to do to make a quote is to split up the budget. I'm going to make one budget for gear, so light, camera, grip, stuff like that. And I'm going to make a budget for the roles that I need. By roles, I mean a cameraman, an editor, a director. Even if I do multiple roles myself, I still split them up on the quote. And then I'm going to multiply the hourly rate by the amount of hours that I need, and then I have my quote finished. Okay, so this is my quote. I've started with the materials, so a camera, LED panels, gimbal set, and stuff like that. Now, these are based on rental prices. Obviously, I have a small margin, and then I go over to the roles. So a director on set, a camera operator, an actor, an editor, a grader, an audio engineer, and also project management. And that is to visit the location, to write the script, to gather all the crew, to brief the crew. And now all the time that is spent in that process is called project management. And I also charge an hourly rate for that. So this is my quote. I'm going to merge it together with my storyboard and my briefing. Then I'm going to send it to Kaylee and present it during a video call. And the only thing she has to do is sign it, and then we can continue scheduling the production, and the deal is closed. For now, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe to this channel if you haven't done that, and good luck.